Namaste and welcome to day 4 of the 21 day yoga challenge. So the past few days we've been going through yoga basics, starting with the Sukshma Vyayam, which is the yogic warm up, moving on to the traditional Hatha Yoga Surya Namaskar, and yesterday we did the Ashtanga Yoga Surya Namaskar A and B. So if you haven't caught those videos yet, do check them out. Going forward, I will be sharing with you 3 to 4 asanas every day, and we will also discuss variations of these asanas and certain modifications for the beginners. We'll also try to squeeze in a few benefits for each of these asanas. And today we'll be focusing on a few shoulder opening asanas, which was requested by a friend of mine, Suma. So let's get started with today's. We'll come to a kneeling down posture. Extend your right leg out to 90 degrees. We will then move it sidewards in the right plane. Now grab hold of your waist and slightly twist it such that your pelvis faces forward. Extend your leg out sideward such that your leg is completely straight. And now try to stretch your foot out to place it entirely on the mat. Once this is done, bring your awareness to your kneecap, and you might notice that it is pointed slightly obliquely. To fix this, we will need to rotate the entire leg from the root of the hip joint. And now you'll notice that your kneecap is pointing towards the ceiling. Extend both your arms out such that it is parallel to the mat, your palms facing downward. Left hand comes on your waist and the right hand extends out as you exhale, trying to reach for your ankle. Now if you can't, then you will reach to your shin and slide downward until you grab the ankle, or you can just place it on the shin. Make sure that your chest is lifted, your pelvis is still facing forward. Now extend the left arm out towards the ceiling. And if this stretch is comfortable for you, then you can bring your hand above the ear for an even greater stretch on the oblique or your left side of the trunk. Stay in this posture for about 20 seconds. And as you inhale, come up. Now for a few variations of this beautiful posture, you can bring your palms together, stretch your hands up, extend the sides of the trunk, lengthen the sides, and as you exhale, bend over to your right side, all the while making sure that your chest and the abdomen is still facing the front. So this is a deep side bend, and as you inhale, come up. Parighasana is really beneficial for those looking to open up their shoulders and their shoulder blades. It also works on expanding the intercostal muscle as well as your abdominal muscle, and gives a good extension to your obliques. And to a certain extent, it also works on opening up the hip joint. And now for a few modifications of this posture for beginners. So you can use something like this to place below your knee. So I'm using a rubber pad, but you could just use a couple of blankets that are folded thick enough. So this is especially useful for those who have knee pain, or in general, it's difficult to keep the knee on a hard surface for a long time. And then to place your extended foot, you can use something like a yoga block. You can place the mound of your feet on a brick, or you can always place it on a wall, and then you can go about doing the asana. Moving on to the second asana of today, which is called the Purvottanasana. So let's come to sitting in Dandasana or the staff pose. Place your palms about 2 to 3 inches behind your hips. Now bend the knees and place your feet on the mat. Roll the shoulders back and bring the chest or the sternum up. The sternum is your chest bone, and in all chest expansion asanas, we always make sure that the sternum is up. Pressing your palms into the mat, lift your hips off the ground and bring it up to a tabletop position. This is Ardha Purvottanasana. and you can drop your head gently back. And now for the complete asana, try to keep the hips in the same position while you extend your feet out. Place your full feet on the mat, including the toes. Press the big toes together, angling the inside of the feet into the mat. Now again, open up the chest completely. The arms are nice and strong. Your glutes aren't too contracted, but your legs are strong. A strong core, and hold this posture for about 30 seconds. And gently come back to sitting in Dandasana. The Purvottanasana is a great posture for the arms as well as for opening up the shoulders. It also works well as a full body exercise, and because you're using the entire body weight and the legs are really, really strong, the core is strong, it serves as a strengthening exercise too. And now for a few variations of the Purvottanasana, both for beginners as well as more intense practitioners. So let's take a look. For this, you will need a yoga block, or you can just roll up any towel and bundle it to this shape and tie it with a crunchy or a rubber band, and it serves just as good. Again, place your hands 2 to 3 inches behind your hip, bend the knees and lift up to the tabletop position. Now in this posture, you will just use the brick to place in between your hips. With this, just squeeze your thighs into the brick, strengthening your legs. This is especially useful for those who cannot extend their legs out. So for the next variation, again, come to tabletop position, extend one leg out and upward. This also strengthens the legs as well as the arms. What you can also do is come up to tabletop as you inhale and just practice extending one leg out instead of both the legs. So take turns and practice to extend one leg at a time. Now you'll notice that it's difficult to place the foot completely on the mat, and that requires a considerable amount of strength. So you can always practice just placing your heels on the mat, expanding the chest out and still keeping the legs strong and holding the asana. And for those of you who require more intense strength conditioning, then you could try this. Come up to Purvottanasana directly and try to lift one leg off the mat and hold this posture. Now for a little more relaxing shoulder stretch, let's come on our fours, such that your knees are directly below the hips and the palms are below your shoulders. Now just to ease off the tension, let's do a couple of cat-cows, that is the Marjasana and Vitilasana. The back and neck are in a straight line. Now as you inhale, bend the belly button towards the mat, concave the back and stretch your neck up. Look up at the ceiling and inhale. As you exhale, bring the chin to the chest and convex the back, pushing it up towards the ceiling. And just one more deep inhalation. Belly push down, look up. And as you exhale, draw your spine towards the ceiling, chin to the chest. Come back to neutral. And now for the chest opener, use your right hand to needle it in between your left arm and extend this hand out further and further away until your right ear and right shoulder touches the mat. And then extend your left arm up towards the ceiling, and for an even expansive stretch, push the hand back. And take deep breaths. Hold this posture for as long as you enjoy the stretch. This provides a good twist for your abs as well as for your back muscles that support the spine. Coming back, place your left hand on the mat and lift up. Now, if reaching out is too difficult for you further than this, then just place your elbow wherever comfortable and extend the right hand up. And this should work well too. And if even this is challenging, then you can place your right elbow just where your palm was and still expand out. Even this gives a good expansion. And just be sure to do it on the other side as well. That's it from me, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's shoulder opening session. Do send me your photos and videos because you never know who you're inspiring, especially in these times of crisis. Do your bit, guys. Stay healthy, stay safe, and namaste.